Then the same 12-year-old says, don't fuck with
dude,
me, Mark.
Dude, it was the 90s, probably a real cigarette.
Yeah,
like,
yeah,
like,
of course, yeah. Yeah. Macaulay Culkin.
My manager called me, see?
They doubled his pay for this cigarette.
Yeah. The insurance company won't cover this, see?
Yeah. And Macaulay Culkin smoked the cigarette like a pro.
Yeah, he knew how to smoke that cigarette. Yeah. He trained for this scene.
Yeah. Method actor.
Yeah. I picked up a habit, you know? Ah, I got the itchy willies here.
I don't know why he's a 1920s newscaster.
And the Ruskies are attacking us. Yeah. Ah.
For this scene, I spent 3 months with smokers.
Yeah.
That's how.
And acting classes where I really immersed myself into the role. I actually got to kill a dog.
This is FFPÖ, your primary source for Austrian film and TV critique. Where two minds come together to take apart the work of people who actually matter.
Welcome back to FFPÖ. My name is Paul and this is episode 85, recorded on the 22nd of September 2018. And he's back after having a literal hit witch hunt or witch escort mission, I guess. He's back. It is
David Stockenreitner.
Hey, David, thank you for being here, man.
Thanks for having me. I remember the season of the witch almost word for word because the words were so shitty. Let's get the fuck out.
It's if somebody says something particularly stupid, it just sticks with you.
Yeah.
Like I had a memory like this from my teenage years when I was in high school and we were on a school trip and the teacher of another class basically, but she was in charge of the trip. Like, she was like, turn the bus around. I'm like, why? I was in the first row because I was like the opposite of the cool kid. I was like the teacher pet. Yeah, and I'm like sitting right there, obviously. And she's like, turn the bus around. And I'm like, why? And she's like, oh, I forgot my phone and my kids at home, but with somebody else. And I want them to call me. I'm like, there's another teacher with a phone here. You know your phone number at home, right? And she's like, yes, I do. And I'm like, yeah, well, then just let him call at home and give the new number and everything is fine. And she's like, no, turn the bus around.
Like, that's not how that works.
Yeah. And then the teacher says exactly the same words I said. And she's like, that sounds like a good idea. And I'm like, and that has stuck with me. Don't you fuck with me, Mark. And we watched The Good Son, the 1993 Macaulay Culkin Elijah Wood vehicle.
Yeah.
And what a vehicle it is.
It's a brilliant movie. I would watch it again.
Crazy. I'm not sure if they would make a movie like that.
No.
With that caliber of actor.
No. It's really good child acting. I mean, one of the children is really fucked up.
It could be like a true crime Netflix show now.
Yeah.
He seemed like a normal kid, but was he?
The confession tapes.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, I killed my little brother.
So we follow the first segment, I guess.
Plot.
There is a little kid played by Elijah Wood. His mom is about to die. He promises her he won't let her die.
Great next promise, scene, kid.
1 second later, mom's funeral.
This fucking movie doesn't fuck around.
Yeah.
It gets into your face like immediately. Yeah.
We are not playing.
Yeah, no, like this is not your regular childhood movie. Yeah. This is your edgy, cool movie.
Yeah, that's right. She died.
Yeah. And the dad is played by
by David Morse.
Yes. Known from TV and mostly TV.
Known from I think almost every good movie I ever saw, he was always in there somewhere.
Yeah, yeah, he's a good bit character actor. And when he plays bigger roles, he's most of the time a corrupt cop or a corrupt politician or just a gangster.
Yeah. Can I take a little detour on this one?
Dude, what if the reason why the parents are so fucking rich is that there are a mobster family and the dad is now under in protective services.
Witness protection program.
Yeah, exactly. That's why they have that crazy house in Maine in the middle of nowhere, like a perimeter around it.
There's police everywhere.
Yeah, let's not get involved.
That's a family matter.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, Jesus. And yeah, so the mom dies, we have a funeral in the middle of the desert, and then the dad decides to drive the son to Maine.
Yeah,
so his uncle can and his okay. uncle's family yeah, can take care of him
while he has to go away for some reason. I can't remember.
To Tokyo, business.
Yeah, right.
They don't get into it. What the dad does.
Yeah, no.
I think it's very much shot from this perspective of a child. Like we only know the broad strokes. They don't explain.
Yeah, we don't know why. We don't know exactly what.
Yeah, exactly.
We just know that the dad loves the boy very much.
But he has to go because that deal will make so much money that he has never work again.
Yeah.
What kind of deal
is
again,
that?
Again, gangster.
Yeah.
Like he's like selling cocaine to the Yakuza.
Like 10 megatons of cocaine.
Oh, welcome, Mr. Powderman.
Mr. Snowman.
Yeah, Mr. Snowman. Yeah.
Welcome, Frosty. Welcome, Frosty.
Frosty, the Coke Man, is a very energetic fellow. He will shoot you in your kidneys if you don't pay his wage. Hey. No, the mind is racing with this movie.
Yeah.
Because it lets you keep thinking the whole time, because it's all build up. The 90 minutes are all build up, except for when Macaulay Culkin's character, who's a demon, basically fucks shit up like a motherfucker.
He is.
We had four or five different things we called him during this. I called him like a tiny mobster.
Yeah. a psycho, a kid joker.
Yeah. Then the guy from Hannibal Lecter.
Yeah, but even Hannibal Lecter would say, dude, that's fucked up.
Yeah, it's really fucked up. Yeah.
That's fucked up. You don't do this to your family.
Yeah, you waste all that meat.
Yeah. Fuck. Eat it. You know how delicious that is. Yeah.
Drowned kid doesn't taste good.
Yeah. It's soft. Dry it up.
Yeah, at least pickle him.
Wet skin doesn't taste good. Have you ever heard about salt?
Salt and pepper, come on. And a little bit of oil, maybe a little bit of onions. That's it.
Garlic.
Delicious. So Macaulay Culkin, so Elijah Wood's character Mark moves in with the family, and through a series of, I don't know, he slowly but surely he finds out that Henry is not...
Henry played by Macaulay Culkin.
Yeah, is not the kid that he thought he was.
Yeah.
Because he has a dark secret.
Major dark secret.
Yeah, a really, really dark secret.
Yeah, and you can see that by the well in the woods where he goes to throw stuff
in. The well is in the cemetery. Why would you put a well in a cemetery in the first place? Mm. That's not where you get groundwater.
Yeah, it's, there is a well in a cemetery and Henry goes there to smoke and to throw stuff in. He smokes.
To get rid of the evidence.
Yeah, yeah.
To get rid of the evidence. That's what he's doing.
The shit he did.
Yeah.
With...
You are flabbergasted by this movie.
Yeah.
This movie really took it out of both of us. I was dying laughing because I couldn't believe my shit. And you were like, can we pause, please? I have to write down 12 different things.
Yeah. And I have almost a page full of a huge notebook here.
Yeah, that's not and that's some good note-taking right there.
And normally,
take note of that, other co-hosts.
Boom. The first time I was here, we watched Season of the Witch, and it was kind of a podcast where we watched the movie for you, so you don't have to. It's not the case with this movie.
I
strongly advise you to watch that movie. Yes, it's very good.
This movie is very, very interesting. Like, we have that car commercial scene where they drive through the desert, and it looks stunning.
Yeah,
amazing. The Las Vegas desert, apparently.
Yeah. So Mark's father,
Nevada,
drives through Nevada in his Jeep with Mark after the mother's funeral.
Yeah.
And it's an establishing shot. They both drive through the desert in the Jeep. And it really looks like a badass car commercial. But the people in the Jeep are desperately sad.
Yeah.
Because the mother died. Badass car commercial, but then sad.
Yeah, it's like it's being like a car commercial made by like a German expressionist.
Yeah, but then sad.
Yeah.
Breathtaking landscape. Yeah. Sad.
Also, he's playing a Game Boy.
Yeah.
Which in 93... Wait, the Game Boy came out, I think, in 86. So he could have had a Game Boy Pocket at this point, I think. Or was the Pocket 95? No.
I think that was 97.
97?
I think so, because I can...
Wait, no, that's color. That's color.
Okay, then maybe 95. But I can clearly remember the TV commercial for the Game Boy Pocket, but I can't remember anything from 1993 because I was 3 years old. But
I would say on a lot of drugs, but oh yeah.
No. Yeah, maybe.
It was my ayahuasca phase.
Yeah. It was still the aftermath from the incubator. They pumped something.
You know why that's the real reason why we don't remember that we're babies? Yeah. Because we take so many drugs. Yeah, okay. Our parents just had us hopped up on morphine the whole time. Yeah. It's astonishing, Paul. Yeah. You were such a quiet kid, yeah.
My first words were Valium.
No, my first words were, give me that smack back, bitch.
If you once go smack, you never go back. Have you ever tried heroin?
Yeah.
You should.
Yeah.
You try
stop horsing around.
Yeah. You try it once, you will never try anything else.
Yeah. It's the one thing you need.
It's the only thing you need in your life.
So, through multiple scenes, we established that Macaulay Culkin is first just a rebel kid, but then it ramps up and it ramps up and it ramps up.
Yeah.
I don't know. Do we want to reveal the specifics? I'm not sure because again, we both want to recommend this movie that people are going to watch it.
Mm.
And it wasn't a very successful movie. Nobody saw it, basically. No.
So but if you're going to see... It's very good.
Yeah.
So I think the stages we go through is first we think he's a rebel kid.
Yeah.
Then
he starts smoking.
Okay, yeah. He starts smoking. They smoke in the woods at the cemetery by the well.
Yeah.
He has a little box with a cigarette.
Yeah, and then we have our first intimidation.
Not a carton of cigarettes, just
a tin box.
With a cigarette.
Like, it's the fucking Second World War, and he's, hiding it from from guards, you know? I'm in internment camp, but I am still a rebel. I could have traded this for food, but, you know, smoking makes you less hungry, so, you know, win-win. You could eat turnip like a chump, or look cool like Mick Jagger. Don't know why I chose him as
I like
coolest person.
I like Beatles. I like Beatles.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's how Prison Camp Riot started. Just the Beatles, Rolling Stones. This how to start a riot in a
I can
in a
get no
prison.
Satisfaction. Yeah, he's right.
Yeah,
it is not satisfying at all.
Yes,
album
was very unsatisfactory. Yes,
satisfactory. I'm working in a satisfactory.
I can get a certain amount of satisfaction.
Under
Russian
these conditions.
Way better.
Under these conditions. So I have to be happy.
So our initial question was, do we want to reveal anything? But I think this Russian bit was solid enough that we don't have to. By the way, no Russians in this movie. So.
No.
This is very much a 93 movie where there's no threat anymore. So who's the enemy? Yeah, that little kid in your house tries to murder you.
Your son.
Yeah. The enemy was in the house all along.
It's 10 o'clock. Do you know where your kids are? No. Well, you should because they're fucking
behind.
Psychos.
Look behind.
Look behind you.
Just a knife.
It's like the faces of Macaulay Culkin is rebel kid. And then, he has a lot of destructive energy. Mm-hmm. And then, oh no, that's something that's something else.
Oh, there's something even
more,
darker inside
more.
Of him buried. Yeah, yeah.
It's getting darker and darker and darker.
I think we can talk about the crossbow.
Yeah.
Because
we should talk about the crossbow.
Because that crossbow was like A-Team / Mad Max together.
Yeah.
That, it looked like something something MacGyver would build.
Yeah.
But in opposite to MacGyver, where nobody dies normally, he fucking has a... That's a killing crossbow.
That's a weapon that you can kill. And he does.
Yeah.
Yeah. He kills a dog.
Yeah, yeah. He snipes a dog. Yeah. And the best thing in that scene is he's like... And the dog walks along the pier and he's like... And then it goes into slow-mo like a real fucking sniper that knows how to lower his
how
heart
to
rate.
How to do that.
Yeah. I saw it in I don't know why he's Russian again, but...
Yeah.
I saw it in documentary once, well, how to snipe dog. This is how you get food, you know?
So you chose a path to be Russian today.
I know why. Yeah. Because of Metro Redux or Metro Last Light, both Russian computer games.
Okay.
That basically it's like after the Third World War.
Okay.
And the people in Moscow just live in the subway system and they're genetically crazy monsters on the because of the radiation on the surface.
Yeah.
So they just live under there and they just make like that crossbow could be straight out of that game.
Okay.
Or vice versa. I guess that game could have straight up stolen that crossbow because it shoots like rusty bolts are shitty in flight. Like they tumble immediately. They don't have a proper, they're not properly weighted. Like
No.
But he still snipes a fucking dog, which means that crossbow is, it has a winch like an old fucking medieval crossbow.
Yeah.
Those things.
He built that himself.
Yeah.
And the barrel is a metal pipe.
Yeah, like a guider.
Where he puts the screw, like the bolt. It's not a screw, it's a bolt. He puts it into the pipe and then he winds it back.
Yeah.
And then the trigger is a brake.
It's from a hose. Or a brake handle?
Yeah, a brake handle from a bike.
I thought it was like from those sprayers from Katina.
Maybe. Kerker.
Yeah, exactly. High pressure water hose. It apparently it creates enough friction so that smoke comes out of the barrel.
After a bolt is fired.
Yeah.
And he tries to kill a cat with it first.
Yeah. And then he's like,
the bolt gets stuck in the tree behind the cat.
Yeah. Holy shit, that's a good bolt. Yeah. And a good crossbow.
Yeah.
It's insane. Like, he's a genius.
Mm-hmm.
Like, Macaulay Culkin's character, Henry, is a certified genius.
Yeah.
He knows how to manipulate people.
Yeah.
Like, really well.
Yeah.
Well, also, his parents are
dog shit.
Yeah, his parents are
the shittiest people on the worst.
Yeah.
We looked at those parents the whole movie through like, wow, you are not only neglectful and bad and abusive, but you're also really dumb. Like, which is the worst combination ever.
They are not, I think they're just dumb.
Yeah.
I think they're just dumb because they don't think.
Hey, we're just trying to be mobsters over here in the protective services.
They don't neglect on purpose.
Okay,
they do that all out of stupidity. I mean, their youngest son died. He drowned in a bathtub.
Yeah, okay, yes.
He drowned in a bathtub.
Sure.
And, well, guess who did it?
Yeah, good night, everybody.
Yeah. And I get the mother's feelings because she goes out on a cliff to think.
Oh, yeah, there's
other
a cliff.
People do.
Guys,
yeah,
there's a cliff. Cliff. Yeah.
There's a cliff. And she stands there like Simba on Pride Rock and thinks.
Totally. Some of the setups were a bit ham-fisted. Like, this is coming back later.
Yeah.
Like the ice skates.
Yeah.
Like
Do you see that? That's important. That's important.
Yeah. Sometimes it's a bit ham-fisted. But again, for a kid murder adventure psycho terror movie, really well executed. And again, Macaulay Culkin and Elijah Wood play amazing.
Yeah, they are very good.
And the chemistry between them, because you really believe that they, through their shared pain, they have something to connect over.
Yeah.
And that is also what creates the rift.
Yeah.
Because Macaulay Culkin, Henry, gets jealous of Mark because Mark lost his mother and he has a replacement mother, basically. And Henry is not cool with that at all.
No. And they are so good, these two child actors, that I really feel sorry for Macaulay Culkin that he got so fucked up later. But because he is a good actor. I mean, when you can do that stuff, that's not for children at all. It's abusive.
This is not a kid's movie.
No, it's not.
For sure not a kid. No. Except for, you know, getting the wrong ideas and trying to kill your parents kind of stuff, you know?
If you're into that, then watch it.
If you want to be the world's worst, if you watch the kids for others, for money.
Yeah, that's au pair, basically.
Yeah, babysitter. Okay,
yeah.
All right.
Yeah, but if you need some inspiration on how to terrorize and maybe kill your parents, then...
This is a really good guide, yeah?
Yeah. Then you should watch it.
Oh, Mr. Highway.
Yeah, okay.
Mr. Highway was pretty dope.
Then let's talk about this. I think we have to talk about Mr. Highway.
Yeah, Mr. Highway is, I think, one of the...
Okay, first of all, Henry, the evil Joker, psychopath kid that could also be played by Jack Nicholson easily.
Yeah, I said James Gandolfini and Jack Nicholson.
Yeah.
Like, that was the original script before they did them in mind, and then they just switched them to kid actors.
So, they dropped out. Who do we have left? This movie would have been pretty dope with adults, and then somebody came up with the idea, let's do it with kids. Are you a fucking psychopath? Okay, let's do it with kids.
I guess so. Yeah, we have those two emerging child actors that need a vehicle.
Yeah.
And that shows off their range.
So, about Mr. Highway. First of all, Henry, the psycho kid, has a little shed.
Yeah,
he builds stuff.
He's a legit murder shack.
Yeah.
It looks like something that some Saw would make from the Saw franchise.
Yeah.
I want to play a game.
I don't know.
I can't do the Saw voice.
That sounded a bit like Tom Hardy. That's nice.
Not like Ed Hardy.
No. Ed Hardy sounds like this.
Durr. And from
2008. So he has this murder shack where he builds stuff in the woods.
Yeah, that crazy crossbow, for example.
Among all these things he builds is a puppet he made himself.
Life size.
Yeah, life size. Who kind of looks a bit like Freddy Krueger.
Or D.B. Cooper, you know.
Yeah.
Potato, potato.
Yeah. And he's called Mr. Highway, which is a pretty creative name. And you don't know why. And the next scene, you know why. It's a puppet. He stands there. Mark and Henry the murder psycho Joker kid stand on a bridge and Henry throws down Mr. Highway Puppet onto a car.
Oncoming traffic, yeah, yeah, exactly.
It's
and because it's winter in Maine, everybody freaks the fuck out and we have a 10-car pile on.
Yeah, we do. We have a mass accident with 10 cars.
And the scene is so long where the cars crash into each other.
It's fucking nerve-wracking.
I solidly laughed for, I think, 10 seconds. Yeah. And then it was still going on.
Yeah. You laughed for 10 seconds and I couldn't.
Because it totally changes the dynamic from, oh, he's just a little bit messed up to, oh, he's a fucking psychopath.
Yeah.
Because this was attempted murder.
I couldn't laugh. So, because he threw a puppet on the highway, 10 cars crash into each other.
Yeah.
And Mark, the not psycho kid, looks at him and basically says, what's wrong with you? And Henry says, what's wrong with you? Don't you know how to have a little fun?
And again, credit to the actors. This could have been so dumb.
Yeah.
So dumb. Especially the scene following that where Mark tries to tell the parents that they caused the pylon. And he talks with Henry. And Henry is talking to him. Yeah. And he's like doing that whole mobster shtick where it's like, oh, who would you believe? Yeah. Nobody wants to get hurt, you know? Like and I could tell them that you did it. Like stuff like that. Yeah. It's like really manipulative and it works so well. Mm. Again, Macaulay Culkin, fucking crazy talented in here.
Yeah.
He's so, like, I would have legit fear in my heart if that kid was around me. I wouldn't stay on that balcony for 1 second.
I think that movie, the alternative title to that movie would be You Don't Wanna Be Home Alone with Kevin.
Yeah. That's Please Don't Leave Me Home Alone with Kevin.
I think from his previous movies, he learned a little something from Joe Pesci.
Yeah, exactly.
All right,
yeah.
Let me tell you something, kid.
Hey, Moff. you goddamn idiot. Yeah, I don't think we want to spoil the ending. I don't
know.
Watch the movie. It is quite surprising.
But
in a way.
What's ridiculously good about the movie is you don't know how this movie ends.
Yeah.
All the time.
It keeps you guessing.
Yeah. Like, I could not imagine how this movie ends. I didn't know.
Yeah, it was awesome.
It's awesome.
We got a flashback. Like, we watched it, something from 93. We both didn't fucking know how it ends. It's not like The Sixth Sense, where it's spoiled to death by everybody.
Yeah.
Here we actually didn't know what happened.
I was guessing.
But it's definitely above a PG-13 because we have a fuck you in here. Which
don't fuck with me.
Which already pushes it, I think, over PG-13. I think PG-13 is allowed one fuck.
Okay.
Allowed one fuck and not always. It's really weird.
Okay.
Like, you can have blood and murder, but you can't have a fuck or something like that.
And there we have... We have a cigarette smoked by a 12-year-old.
Yeah.
And then the same 12-year-old says, don't fuck with
Dude,
me, Mark.
Dude, it was the 90s, probably a real cigarette.
Of course, yeah. Yeah. Macaulay Culkin.
My manager called me, see?
They doubled his pay for this cigarette.
Yeah. The insurance company won't cover this, see?
And Macaulay Culkin smoked the cigarette like a pro.
Yeah, he knew how to smoke that cigarette. He trained for this scene.
Yeah. Method actor.
Yeah. I picked up a habit, you know? I got the itchy willies here. I don't know why he's a 1920s newscaster. the Ruskies are attacking us. Ah.
For this scene, I spent 3 months with smokers.
Yeah.
That's how.
And acting classes where I really immersed myself into the role. I actually got to kill a dog. Michael Wick led me.
What's it? Yeah, that's how.
Oh, who had dogfight rings in the 90s? Michael Vick was in the 2000s, I think. But who was it in the 90s?
I don't know, but
there was a guy.
That's how Jared Leto a goddamn idiot would prepare for this scene. I spent 3 months with smokers.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not even the most important aspect of the movie.
No.
Like,
I just hate Jared Leto. I don't know why.
Yeah. No. Jared Leto and Joaquin Phoenix, on the other hand, does the same thing, but his roles turn out to be through the bank good. Better. Yeah, better. Good. Yeah. Way better. And like, Joaquin Phoenix then, yeah, I did the same thing, but what I did, I spent 3 months with smoking Indonesian kids.
Yeah. Yeah. But some of those were
really fucked up.
But the difference is, I'm a good actor.
Like, I do what you do, but only good. Let's move on to
cinematography.
This looked great. Some of it looked really well lit and well shot.
Yeah, yeah.
Like the panoramic shots of the woods and the desert looked, again, car commercial level.
Yeah,
like
it looked really nice.
But then again, you know that it is a fairly low budget production, because we see the wires in two different scenes.
Yeah, we see wires.
Don't leave us hanging. Tell us more about the wires. The suspension is killing me.
That was good.
I'm hanging on a thread over here.
That was a good one with the suspension. Yeah, we have wires in this movie, which I think
no wonder that
weren't visible
shouldn't
in 1993.
Have been, yeah, on the TV.
But as you said, HD ruined everything.
Yeah, exactly. We have one where they try to snipe out the cat,
yep.
And the bolt just lands in the bark on top of it, and you see that the bolt just is guided on a wire, just like whoop.
Yeah,
and it looks fine. Again, the special effects, it's not what the movie is about. It's, again, a psychological thriller film from 93. And it was on a $17 million budget, which I'm assuming is $12 million to get Macaulay Culkin, $4 million to get Elijah Wood, and the rest is the rest of the budget.
Yeah. And the second wire, no, we can't tell you.
It's at the end. It's when...
Yeah.
But
there is a wire.
Cliffhanger right there.
There is a wire.
What was interesting to me was the scene where they run through the forest. There's a separate scene where Elijah Wood runs through the forest, and then there's a scene where Macaulay Culkin at the end runs through the forest.
Yeah.
And it's shot basically in exactly the same way, with the only difference being that they run from the viewer's perspective in opposite directions.
Yeah, yeah.
Is that like some kind of... like they're both lost boys in the woods and they don't know what to do with their feelings, but one runs in the right direction and the other one doesn't. Like, is that like some kind of symbolism, or am I, again,
I don't know,
putting way too much thought into something like that?
I just think Henry the psycho kid doesn't have any feelings. He just knows how to imitate emotions.
Yes,
and that's what a real psycho makes.
Yeah, like, yeah. This is one of those feelings, bleep blorp. Yeah, exactly. Stab, stab. Yeah.
Cry now.
Yeah, exactly.
It is expected of you. That's what a psychopath does.
Anything else?
Let's see. I have...
visual.
Sometimes when Elijah Wood runs, the camera is very close to his face all the way, so that you lose every sense of direction.
That's true. When he runs out the house and gets hit by the football.
Yeah, because Macaulay Culkin's character Henry is always under control of the whole situation. Elijah Wood basically never is.
That's true. Yeah.
You see that right away. Like he's like Christoph Waltz. Macaulay Culkin is like Christoph Waltz. He's always a step ahead. Whatever you tell him, he already knows.
Yeah.
And everything he does is a game, and he is always 100% in control of the situation, even with his own mom.
And yeah, when they have that interrogation scene in the shed, and he's like, no, I just want to dance around the subject, you know?
Yeah. Where you got it from? Tell me, that's interesting.
Yeah. Tell me more, mother.
Yeah, mother.
Mother. That would have pushed it like into insane territory where it's like, mother.
You would like that, wouldn't you?
Mother, yes.
Yes.
Yeah. Like the fucking guy from Arrested Development. Mother! The guy with the hook. Mother! Yeah. That's basically if he grew up to be an adult that didn't want to kill people. Really fucked up.
Sounds.
So that's the Austrian connection, by the way, guys. It's the soundtrack is composed by Elmer Bernstein.
Yes.
Who has his father or his mother has
Austrian roots.
Austrian roots, and the other one has Ukrainian roots, which, you know, back then, basically Austria again. It depends on the region. But yeah, the soundtrack is amazing.
It's 90s, but
it's super 90s. Yeah, the only thing is missing is an oboe, said.
Yeah, oboe. I never heard an oboe once.
Or one of those jazz saxophones.
Yeah. I think that tells you that it's not a family movie. Maybe. I don't know. Maybe that's...
It's not bum 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 bum. It's not Seinfeld.
Yeah. It's, I think...
What is it with those kids that always try to murder everybody?
I think...
This is ridiculous!
I think the first sign of this movie being a psychological fuck-up is the absence of an oboe. I think that's what it is in the soundtrack.
That's why...
Home Alone is all grown up now. And he tries to do whatever he can to keep his family together. It's like Taken, but...
I can live without a family. I was home alone before.
Yeah. I'm home alone schooled.
God damn it.
You know what? You owned your right to do puns.
Yeah.
Because you've been doing it for a long time.
Yeah.
And if you can pull that off... For such a long time.
No, while everybody, it's a shtick.
Yeah, while everybody else is hating you for it, that's really rock and roll, and I can respect
really
that.
Really rock and roll. Yeah. I like it. Motherfucker.
That's rock and roll.
And I like it. I like it. Yes, I do.
It's only rock and roll, but I like it.
Also, apparently, I'm now doing the Duke Nukem voice. Oh, chewing bubble gum and making puns. And I'm all out of gums. Puns. Gums.
Do you want to hear a Forrest Gump pun?
No, but...
Pun, Forrest, pun.
My mother always said, life is like a box of chocolates.
Life is like a box of chocolates. Shitty for diabetics, isn't it? My mama always said, sexy is who sexy does. They want to see my chest hair.
My mama always said, our genetic defects are hereditary.
My mother always said,
I never had that kid.
My mother always said, freak, freak, freak. Freak.
My mama always said, hey, retard, give me the remote.
realistic Forrest Gump. He just had really shitty parents, so he imagined this all.
I found apple and I ran into the forest. Yeah, this is all totally true, guys.
He's actually sitting in the woods naked with a bunch of squirrels. Who resent him?
But they bring him the nuts, and he has like,
I have a box of chocolate. Those are nuts, man. Chocolate. All those squirrels can't speak. What?
I'm actually trying to work out a more realistic version of Batman.
Yeah.
It's like also, it's slightly different in some points. It's still Bruce Wayne. His parents get gunned down in front of his eyes.
Mm-hmm.
But he doesn't have the money to travel the world and get trained as a ninja or whatever.
Yeah.
And also, he doesn't have the emotional support of a British butler / father figure. Yeah. So he just starts taking meth.
And dies.
Yeah.
<That's> nice. Yeah. Meth man.
He's got some crystal.
His teeth are bad. Rehab.
Hey, can I talk to you about that thing? He has the power of feeling ants under his skin.
And his special move, rip off face and eat.
Right. Best moment.
Imagine Batman ripping off a guy's skin and slurps it in like spaghetti. Yes.
Oh, this was delicious. Nutritious face. Face the facts, punk.
You'll feel lucky.
This punk. Criminal justice system is fucked up if they let a person like me avenge people.
They don't. They hunt you night and day. The police force and the mayor are strictly against you, except for that one dude that has a shining light in the sky for some reason.
Yeah, he's a really good dude. Yeah. What is
Commissioner Gordon is a great friend of mine. What? Oh, too much said. All right. What was your best moment, man? Except for this one, because this one was pretty sweet already. This was a great bit.
My best moment. I don't.
I love the crossbow.
Yeah,
the crossbow. Yeah. When they reveal the crossbow and see how fucked up he really is for the first time.
Yeah, I think
my personal favorite was when the sister broke in the on the ice.
Yeah,
ice skating.
That was also my favorite moment.
It really played with my own fears that I had as a kid.
Yeah.
Because I used to skate on frozen ponds too, and my dad was also like, "Don't drive out too far because
I won't help you.
It gets too thin." Yeah, no, I can't help you because I'm heavier than you. Also, those two dudes are like those lumberjack
house. Yeah.
Those main, real mains. Those were some real mains over there.
No, it's also my greatest moment of the movie. I think I will think about this moment for a very long time, I think.
Yeah.
Maybe for the rest of my life, I don't know. I don't know, maybe.
You don't go ice skating too often, right?
No. I don't do stuff. I don't do stuff.
How would you? Like a wheelchair kind of deal?
I once knew how to ice skate. I was good at it.
Once upon a time.
Yeah, once upon a time in elementary school. But nowadays, I don't do stuff. Like, if somebody asks me, "Hey, do you want to go to the..." No.
No, I
don't want to go. I don't. But
the word "go" was spoken, so yeah, no.
No. It's I don't want. I don't want to.
Do you want to stay? Yes.
Yeah. I don't do stuff.
Yeah.
I don't.
Yeah. You're a perfect example of the second law of Newton's law thingy. An object won't be put into motion except if an extreme external force. No, I fucked that up.
Yeah, real I think bad. So too. I don't know that law, and even I think so.
I didn't Newton that. Secret category
is Macaulay Culkin's character Henry on steroids,
because he's freakishly strong in some scenes.
He's very strong.
He holds Elijah Wood's character over a ridge and pulls him up.
Yeah,
just like
yeah.
That was crazy. He
could be.
He was really roided up.
Yeah, but then again, he is very calm.
Yeah, and then he explodes again. Like, he's on steroids. Or, you know, he puts like an unusual amount of nicotine. That's it. That's why he has like this.
Yeah.
He's just super addicted to nicotine.
He's just a smoker.
Yeah. Oh, you can relate.
Yeah, I'm not that strong, but...
But wait until I haven't smoked for 2 days, then I'm gonna fucking kill you.
I'm gonna Nobody shows as much focus and enthusiasm as a smoker looking for a cigarette.
That's true. You should see that. Also, all societal gates fall. He asks anybody. Somebody who really needs a smoke, he will go up to an 8-year-old and is like, hey, kid, hast du die Zigarette?
Yeah, yeah.
Or the reverse, where it's like, where he already has the cigarettes, but no fire to light, no lighter.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and then there's like, do you have a lighter? Do you have a lighter?
In school, they taught us you're addicted to cigarettes if you go out buying cigarettes at any weather, like storm or hail. And now I know, no. With storm or hail, a real smoker stays at home.
And orders it over.
Ripping his house apart
in search of
a cigarette, mm-hmm. because he is searching at spots he looked at 5 minutes ago but didn't find any.
Oh man, yeah. So yeah, Macaulay Culkin was really morided up in this one.
Yeah, he was strong kid.
Yeah, fucking strong kid. Yeah, he again could hold up his energy against his mom too. So
yeah, a long time when they were struggling with that duck. Yeah. And this was the first time he actually wasn't in control over a situation.
Mm-hmm.
And then you saw him break.
Yeah, true.
He really panicked and he broke.
Amazing.
And that was beautiful to see.
That was really good. Well played, too. Like, again, hat off to both of them.
I mean,
the parents were also worse actors, which is hilarious.
Yeah, yeah.
Especially the dad.
Yeah.
Oh, the dad was so useless.
He was so fucking useless.
He was a human garbage pile.
He didn't care.
In a sweater.
I mean, they wanted to portray him as a nice father, but then he didn't care about his children at all. He was just sitting in front of his 1990s computer.
Oh, no, dude, that was a green and black 1980s. Screen. That's like he's old school. Like he's like,
yeah.
Oh yeah, this is I an don't original need that M- new stuff. IBM.
I don't need that new stuff.
Yeah. Back in my day, we didn't use interfaces.
We didn't use a floppy disk.
Yeah. We had those newfangled hard drives. It's all on stamped cards.
He didn't particularly care about the kids.
No.
Hey, Mark's fighting. Yeah, stop it. That's all he did.
Yeah.
Because he was playing solitaire on his computer or whatever. and I couldn't help but thinking, what would this father do as soon as he discovers internet porn?
Yeah, no. Like, the moment he found porn, he would have been locked in that room forever.
He would get a divorce, I think.
Because his wife is always standing on the computer.
She can have everything except for the computer.
He can have as many cliffs as she wants.
Yeah, I buy you the cliffs. I buy you a landscape to think on.
Yeah. Look, this Windows 95 PC has a wallpaper of a cliff.
Yeah. And I thought, now in the 90s, you just don't care that much about your kids because you're playing solitaire.
Mm-hmm.
If that was in 2010, he would completely neglect and starve the family to death.
Yeah, because he
was watching Chinese girls pooping into each other's mouths. I think that's the kind of guy. Because the actor himself, he also looks like L. Ron Hubbard.
Fat L. Ron Hubbard. Yeah, true. Real sweater guy. Yeah. A real dad.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, like if they put the version of an American dad into one person, it would be this guy with the funky looking hair too. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a mixture of Michael Rapaport and Ronald Weasley.
That's pretty good. He looks like white version of what's his name? And he puts the pills in the pudding.
Buffalo Bill.
No, what?
Bill Cosby.
Bill Cosby. Okay. Yeah, he looks like pre-trials Cosby.
Yeah. Well, the after trials Cosby was still like, hey, I'm going to prison.
hey, you're stabbing me. Somebody's shanking him and he's like, hey.
Ow, ow, ow. I don't know who Michael Rapaport is. I don't know where I know him from. I just know the name.
Okay.
I kind of know what he looks like. He had a very short-lived sitcom, I think.
Maybe. I mean, I feel like we're in a Michael Trapper pod right now, and we're getting out of this.
Ooh, a pun.
Yeah, so, only technically. That was technically a pun.
Final conclusion.
What do you think of The Good Son? Watch it, guys. Watch the fucking movie.
Yeah.
It's a great movie.
It's really good.
Well written.
It's the best child acting I've ever seen.
Yeah, in a long time for me. Yeah. For me a long time. The kid from Funny Games. Yeah, I love him. Love him. He was really, really good.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Stranger Things is also...
amazing, yeah.
Amazing child actors.
True. But it's rare. It's very rare to see two really good child actors bounce off of each other.
Yeah.
And having the parents involved only tangentially, like the real actors. And
I'm really wondering where did they learn that?
Child actors? Acting comes naturally to a certain degree.
Yeah, I believe.
And you know, you have those one in a million things where Mozart is fucking composing stuff when he was seven or some bullshit
like that.
So you have actors who are like just naturally gifted in that regard. Of course, they still have to train to become truly good, especially because again, the bar is so much lower. Again, we were like, it's probably Al Pacino and Jack Nicholson level, you know?
Yeah, yeah. But the act, it's really good. It's a really good movie, and the overall story is also really good.
It's intriguing. Yes,
there is stupid
sometimes, contrived at points.
Yeah,
but
a bit, but there is nothing really cringeworthy about.
Oh,
except
absolutely
for the
not.
Mother standing on the cliff thinking,
"Fuck that mother!
Fuck the mother! Fuck that mother!
That mother is crazy and puts out crazy babies."
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
he squeezes out psychopaths. She, sorry, I don't.
Or kids who can't swim in a bathtub.
And little kids, infants who can't swim in a bathtub.
Idiots, ooh. Idiots all around.
Oh yeah, the last photo she has of her youngest son who died and who drowned in the bathtub. He has that bathing rubber duck with him in the picture. That's really cringeworthy and also very funny. It's fucking funny.
It was funny.
He has that rubber duck.
Yeah.
It's a very beautiful picture. Like a stock photo.
It looks like something when you pick it up at the frame store, they have it in there already.
They still have that there. And he has that little rubber duck. It's a rubber duck you go into the bathtub with.
Yeah.
Where he drowned.
All right.
It's a good movie.
Where can people find you?
I also do stand-up comedy in German. Yes. I'm writing...
for the Indian audience.
Yeah. Hello, India. Yeah.
Duck, duck, duck. David is playing his one-man comedy show. Stuhl, bitte.
No.
No.
I'm
new
writing,
program?
Yeah, I'm writing for my second program. The working title is Down Syndrome 2.0. It's a little bit too edgy. I won't stay with that. I really want to. That's retarded good. I really want to, but in order to understand that, you would have to know a few things about me.
Getting down with the syndrome.
Don't let the syndrome
down
bring
with
you.
The syndrome.
Syndrome of a down. It's not mine, but it's
getting
good.
Down with the syndrome.
Wake up.
You're gonna live with the biggest. I'm getting angry letters. I feel it right now. So yeah, so you're writing on your second show?
Yeah.
Nice.
I hope it's gonna be good. I don't know yet.
Well, that's what all artists think.
I'm really working on it, but
right on,
otherwise,
man.
On Facebook, David Stockenreitner. Comedy.
Link in the description below.
Yeah, please.
Just click the link.
I don't want...
You're dying over there, man. What is happening to you? No, you're melting into the couch.
Yeah, because of my last name. It's so not marketable.
Die Stockenreitner, yeah. I mean, you could be just DS or...
No, because if people can handle Schwarzenegger, they should be able to... Yes.
Yeah.
Without forgetting the N in the middle. please, yeah. because everybody does that. So it's Stockenreiter. No, Stockenreitner. What the fuck?
Yeah.
But yeah, well, people have problems with the N-word.
Yes.
Okay, I think we should wrap this up before we get
your name could
live
be,
hate mail.
Could be David, Itsy Bitsy, Stumbleweenie.
Yeah.
Fall over that step machiney.
Yeah.
Very easy name. All forms of support that many characters. Yeah. All right, guys. It has been a pleasure. It was good, son, to hang out with you guys.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having me.
It was hilarious. And guys, see you the next time. Oh, yeah. There is maybe a Patreon already up. I'm not sure. But if there is,
You're going to do that?
Yes. Yeah. I want some money, man.
Yeah.
I'm putting those up in Creative Commons so people can download them, remix them or whatever, but there is some production cost involved in this. It's more or less a hobby right now, but if you have some loose change, online change around, I also accept Bitcoins. Crypto. I also accept crypto. No, I don't know what payment methods, Patreon, but there's gonna be some extra tiers, like you can call me, for example. I will give you, if there's a certain tier, you can have a nice chat for me for an hour or so every month.
Ask me anything.
Yeah, basically, an AMA basically with me. Yes, truly, dearly, dearly, truly, truce, dearly.
Dearly.
Truce, dearly. That's my new internet handle name. Truce, dearly.
Welcome to 5 o'clock news. My name is Truce Dearly, and I have here in my studio a guy who doesn't know how to close off a show. So, a guy who doesn't know how to close off a show. How do you feel about this ending of this episode?
Yeah. All right, bye.
Bye. Oh, no, we stole that from Michelle Wolf.
Oh, fuck me.
Oh, fuck me. Oh, we can't say bye.
Too bad that Michelle Wolf's show already got cancelled.
Really?
Yeah, it did.
Oh,
so
shit.
I can do this Duke Nukem voice again. I came here to rip off cancelled shows and chew bubblegum. And I'm all of... Oh, damn, this is really bad for my voice. All right, guys, bye.
Bye.